So a few weeks ago, maybe a few months ago even, there was a gentleman called Mr. Davinder Guy who won a court case at the High Court of Justice to be cremated on open air funeral pyres. Now I want to know why he took that case all the way to the High Courts of Justice. What is the reason for Hindus to be cremated on an open air funeral pyre?
Okay. This is a morbid question to start off with, but we'll still go for it. You see, as I said, if you know the why of your religion, you can take into account the changing context in which you find yourself and decide how to put your religion into practice. That is very crucial. This Hindu religion prides itself in evolving all the time. It says we are not set in a rut. So it is open to evolution. And he says the practices that you kind of carry out, like say some of the ceremonials, can evolve and take into account the changing context in which you find yourself. It allows you to evolve. The Graha Sutras allow you, they say that the stipulation we are making regarding how you cremate, etc., must take into account the context in which you find yourself. So you see, the idea is this. We live in modern United Kingdom. See, indoor crematoriums are very far less gruesome than open air cremation. Most of you never experience an open air cremation, so let me tell you what it is. To give you a little bit of a shudder. Open air cremation sometimes takes place, say in India, of course, there's no other way. They have open air, they don't have indoor crematorium, they don't have the facilities, so they have open air cremations. Here, the body is sometimes left to burn for perhaps 5 or 6 hours. It takes that long for the body to burn, to put pieces of wood on it and ghee on it and keep burning it. And the relatives have to stand around, and you see they get this smell of the burning flesh all the time with the near and dear ones. At the end of the cremation, you may not know these things. It's good for you to know and ask. The male relative, the son, has to climb over the funeral pyre, get a club, and break the bones and the skull. Okay? Now, why do Hindus cremate, first of all? The reason why Hindus cremate is because they say those elements that combine together to produce this body, let them go back to their own nature. Let them go back to nature. So rather than preserve them, the Indic religion said the body is an outer garment, just an external garment. When a person is dead, the thing that was living is left. So don't hang on to the external. Discard it. And in fact, let it go back to nature. And the way you do it is through cremation, rather than just hold it in a ground where it kind of rots. So let it go back to nature. That's the whole idea behind the cremation theory. That's a straightforward idea. Now, you see, in India today, if you go to villages, the only way you can cremate is open a cremation. There's nothing else. In cities in India, they're putting an indoor crematorium left, right, and center, all over India. So, does it mean that somehow we are compromising our religion? Provided you understand what's the idea behind cremation, to dispose of the body, to cremate the body as quickly, as hygienically as possible, as early as possible, rather than let it rot and smell and all that. Dispose of the body in a hygienic manner. Now, if you can do this without being gruesome or becoming less gruesome, why shouldn't you do that? Does your religion say, no, it's written, you must do it open air? It doesn't say things like that. So you see, this is the reason why this was a very contentious issue. And many Hindus said, look, the Muslims asked for this, the Jews asked for this, so they get it, so why can't we get it? Well, they are stuck in a rut. Their religion is not allowed to evolve. Your religion is allowed to evolve. So why don't you evolve? And you see, the one thing I like about Darwin is this. Darwin says, lovely stuff. Hinduism loves Darwin, loves evolution. He says, if you don't evolve, you die. So when a religion stops evolving, that means it's no longer a living religion. It's a dead duck. It's just antiquated ideas, just hang on to. It doesn't work. A society moves on. They say some of these ideas are outdated now. And the sell-by date is gone. Can we evolve? Your religion says, evolve, my friends, evolve. So this was the issue behind this idea of open cremation. But some people are fixated. It's an issue of tradition. It's an issue of somebody thinks very idyllic. You know, it's kind of nice and kind of, you've seen these ZTV films, you know, where somebody being cremated open air and the sun is setting and all that. They want to do that. See, good for them. Look, the Hindu religion does not step onto anybody's human rights, saying that, no, you must only cremate in indoor. It doesn't say that. It says, look, just think for yourself and decide which particular method you want to adopt. Provided you do not offend people that you are living with. And provided you take into account that the gruesome, you know, agenda that you're taking on, please take care, evolve, be a living religion. This is the whole idea behind this idea of open cremation. And this is why it is sometimes necessary to tell the Hindus, please grow up. You know, half the time I spend is not just educating the non-Hindus, but educating the or re-educating the Hindus about Hinduism, saying, look deeply in your religion and come up with a better solution. Not to compromise on anybody's human rights. We don't do that. If somebody wants to say, I want to cut my body cut into small pieces and fed to the fish in the river Ganga, I say, that's good for you. We will not interfere. That's human rights. At the same time, think for yourself. And don't say, this is written in my book. I hate that. It must be open. Your book is very open. It's a constantly evolving story. So please take care.